everyone. Yes, so if you could just stand a little in the front for our photographers, oh, yeah. Just for one, two pictures, and then we'll get into a chat. Okay, 1 second. I'm just also going to make sure. Yeah? Okay.
Don't forget.
All right, so all you wonderful gentlemen, we also have an event that we're doing over here. Okay, we'll give them a chance for more pictures also. Yeah, come. That's for you. Yes, please.
So I want to welcome all of you to our little skin date and take this opportunity to say how honored I am to represent this iconic brand which has been with me for years, that helps me celebrate me, and thank you for being here.
I know that the girls have their own set of questions that they will have for you, but before that, I just really need to ask you, I know that you probably have a really hectic schedule, you always probably have a really hectic schedule, and yeah, and I mean, just look at you, you're really glowing right now.
Thank you.
It's not just the lights. So I knew you were going to say that.
It's your love.
It's the love in the room. But really, I mean, long hours, being under these lights, all of that.
I believe that health, your skin is a reflection of health, and great skin should never be taken for granted.
Yeah.
And especially a great skincare routine should never be ignored. And the most important part of a great skincare routine is definitely moisturization.
Mm.
And I know it makes it difficult for me to have like a long drawn process.
Yeah.
But I make sure I make time for moisturization, and my go-to product is Deep Resto.
And I love how it's actually really tiny. I know, I'm sure it also comes in a
because
bigger this
it can fit into the to my bag.
Yeah. Because
when I don't find time, I make sure I have it in my bag, this and this, actually in my bag all the time, so I can apply it on the go.
So while you also have beautiful skin, there's a lot of people that we tend to admire as well and say, you know, oh God, even she has such lovely skin. Is there someone like that on your list?
For me, Hema Malini is the ultimate beautiful woman who I cannot stop looking at whenever I see her.
Yeah, she's so iconic and so timeless.
Skin, I don't know how it glows all the time.
Eternal beauty. Makeup is a very important part. And I mean, if you look around the room, everyone, you know, has a little bit of makeup on. And that is something that we always have. And then you have the paparazzi for a person like you, who are also always around. But there's some days that they manage to kind of catch you off guard, right? Like you've suddenly gone somewhere.
I hope someday they have to be camera ready all the time. Really.
So, but then what do you do? How do you kind of make sure that you're camera ready all the time?
Yeah. Fortunately or unfortunately, because of my profession, I don't have a choice, especially nowadays, but to be camera ready.
Yeah.
And confidence actually comes from having great skin. So you can just walk out and go anywhere, even if you don't have a trace of makeup, and feel that I'm doing fine for the cameras, you know?
Yeah.
And I think that comes from a combination of things like having a good diet and exercising regularly.
Right.
moisturizing,
yeah,
and most importantly, sleeping well and sleeping enough.
Yeah.
So yeah, those are the key factors.
Are you one of those people that can just manage to take a nap anywhere just to make sure that you're getting in enough sleep?
No, I sleep early and I wake up early. I make sure I pack up early from my shoot.
Lucky. So while we've had this, you know, whole chat about our skin and moisturization, and we're also talking about things that we've been told, right? Or we're experiencing ourselves. But what I also want to do is I want to kind of extend the conversation to an expert as well and just really understand the kind of dynamics that do take place and how it really works when it comes to our body and it comes to our skin. So please, with a big round of applause, with your permission, ladies, can we welcome into this conversation Dr. Aparna Santanam. She's a renowned celebrity dermatologist, and I'm sure she's going to give us a lot of tricks and hacks and lead in this conversation. Hi. Yes. Hi. Hi. Yes, doctor. That's definitely for you. So, doctor, like you just heard our conversation right now, you know, we know, we've been all told, right, from a long time, moisturize, and moisturizing is very essential. And we know that as something. But what actually happens to our skin when we moisturize it, and what happens when you don't?
Right. First of all, thank you so much for having me here. And let me say what an honor it is to share a stage with Tabu, one of my absolute favorite actresses. And hello, all of you. I see a lot of familiar faces here as well. It's a very interesting question that you asked me, because most people don't understand what moisturization actually means.
Hmm.
I get a lot of people who talk to me thinking that you're adding something to the skin. So you actually pick up a product and you're putting something which is going to add something or enhance your skin. The simple truth is that the skin itself is more than 90% water, which is an equivalent for moisture. Now, if the skin is already 90% water, why do we need to put something on it is a very valid question. What happens all the time on the skin is like a sieve. We constantly gain things from outside and we lose things to the atmosphere.
Hmm.
So right now I'm sitting here, I've been sitting here in this room for the last 1 hour,
yeah,
in a temperature that is not most suitable for me because it's really cold. So what's happening in this weather is that the moisture from my skin is moving outward. So when I get up and go out from here, I'm definitely going to feel like my skin is drier, even though I have used a moisturizer in the morning. This is called as transepidermal water loss, where your skin is constantly losing moisture. Secondly, in our everyday lives, we're exposed to so many different elements, like we're out in the sun, there's pollution outside, there's a certain kind of diet that we eat which tends to strip moisture from the skin. Now, all of this needs to be replaced, and the moisture in our skin needs to be locked in. And that is the main function of a good moisturizer. Something that gets into your skin, locks in your own beauty ingredient, which is actually just water which hydrates the skin, and therefore helps the skin to function much better. And the skin is not just a beauty organ. You know, we often look at it as saying it provides us glow, it provides us confidence, like Tabu said, to go out and face the world, because the first thing people notice about us is our skin. But the skin is also a very, very important functioning organ, in the sense that it acts as a barrier. If we didn't have the skin when we went out, all our internal organs would be exposed all the time. So imagine what the poor heart and the kidney and the lungs would do if there was no skin covering it. And just like any barrier, like the wall we have or the ceiling, every barrier tends to develop cracks. And it is these cracks that a moisturizer actually seals, like cement in between the bricks on the wall. And the cement is constantly lost, which needs to be replenished by the moisturizer, to just explain it in as simple terms as possible.
But then what happens to someone like me who sometimes thinks like it's okay if I don't moisturize today, you know, I'm in a big hurry and it's theek hai, like it's be that one thing. I'll probably be like, okay, I better put my kajal today before I leave the house, but maybe I can skip that. So what happens in a case like, do you ever do that? Does that ever happen? It's always there in your bag.
No, I think that's a very, very sensible approach to always have a moisturizer with you.
Yeah.
Because it's one of your hidden, you know, today's a secret date with Tabu, and a moisturizer is actually your secret weapon to great skin. So it's not that if you don't use a moisturizer today, you may see the effects today.
Mm-hmm.
But definitely there are effects in your skin. You tend to develop, like the wall develops little cracks. You know, living in Bombay, we all know how there's seepage in the walls. The seepage doesn't happen overnight. So you develop these little cracks which cannot be seen, which are eventually seen in the form of poor glow on the skin,
right,
and inability of the skin to repair itself, so we start aging faster. And because we start aging faster, the glow gets diminished further.
Why do that when you have this? At any point, if there's anything you also want to ask, please go ahead.
Actually, there are two questions. One is, what is the truth about moisturizing at night? Good, recommended, not, and what happens when you sleep?
That's a great question, Tabu, actually. See, there are two reasons why it is much better in places like India and especially places like Bombay to moisturize at night. One is that during the daytime when you're out in the sun all the time, you're sweating. So a lot of products that you may put on your skin may actually feel a little stickier,
yes,
may feel a little bit more uncomfortable if you have to layer them on in the daytime. Right. Secondly, what we do during the day is actually heaping insults on ourselves, right? In every single way, we're outside, we forget to hydrate ourselves, we don't drink enough water. If we are, you know, in your case, shooting for a long period, or even other people who are traveling out to work and coming back, very often you forget to do the little thing saying, I need to moisturize my skin, let's say, after 6 hours or 8 hours. So the skin is undergoing micro damage right through the day. When we come back home in the evening and we're actually unwinding and we're getting to bed, that's the time when we have a little more time to focus not only on the face, but essentially on the body, which is a very neglected part of most people's beauty routine. You
right.
know? Most of us in India never look neck below to see what we can do to our body. Everything is about the face. But at night, you do have the time and the mind space to actually pick up a moisturizer and focus on those areas, one, which tend to get drier, mm-hmm. and two, which tend to become drier over time, even chronologically. There are certain parts of the body which age faster,
yeah.
which kind of skin we have. Now, obviously, this is not a golden rule, but I've seen in India, most people, even when you've got an oily skin on your face, tend to have dry skin on their bodies. And certain areas, especially hands, feet, elbows, knees, tend to be constantly dry. Secondly, feet especially. In India, we all tend to walk and play barefoot when we are younger, and we don't pay as much attention to our feet, so it does tend to get very, very dry. So one, it's important to understand whether you have dry skin on your face and body, very dry skin or normal to dry skin. Secondly, it's also very important to look at the ingredient listing of any moisturizer you pick up. There are certain ingredients which are very, very good for the skin, but also leave the skin feeling cosmetically elegant. Light liquid paraffin is one such ingredient which penetrates well into the skin, tends to hydrate the skin extremely well, also deep repairs the skin and yet manages to not leave the skin looking sticky or messy. It's also
I was just doing a PG rating here, but okay. But ladies, just to pick up on what doctor just said, we also have arranged a moisture meter here for you because, you know, Tabu also was very keen that everyone should understand what kind of skin you have and that the routine is correct to your skin. So when this whole conversation is done and, you know, after you finish all your one-on-ones, don't forget we've got that experiential zone where you can also go and test it. Because a lot of us tend to feel like, okay, I know what my skin type is, but I truly believe that it's going to change in the next couple of days. Because it'll change with the weather, right?
Yeah. I think, you know, one of the things to understand is the skin is not a static organ.
Yeah.
Every 30 days we get new skin on the top layer. And the skin is constantly moving and changing. So what product may suit you in the month of May may necessary.
Let's give doctor a round of applause. But thank you for clearing so many concepts as well for us.
Yes,
yeah. Topic. Yes. Thank you, doctor. So just to now understand, you know, I'm sure you have a lot of beauty secrets as well. No? Of course you do. Sleep. No, but I mean, even when we were chatting just a little earlier, you were also telling me,
yeah. Is actually really this.
Can you take the mic? It's there. Yeah.
My go-to product is actually really this. Actually, I've been using it for years, even before I was the brand ambassador of Vaseline Petroleum Jelly, and I'm genuinely saying it.
Yeah.
And I've been using this for chapped lips, dry skin, especially when I used to shoot in really cold climates, Switzerland and all those places, this was the only thing that was my, like a rescue remedy kind of a thing. And I also use this for removing my eye makeup and mascara. Yeah.
Ooh.
I remember years back,
yeah,
a dermat had suggested this to me.
Okay.
And they were like, there's nothing better than petroleum jelly for you to remove your eye makeup.
Okay.
And use as a moisturizer, under eye moisturizer at night. So this I swear by. This I always have in every corner of the house, in every bag I might use, on my shoot, in my vanity van, everywhere, just in case. I miss it.
Yeah. And actually, this will be the season when we're going to want to like reach out for it the most. But what I love is how they make it in that really small size.
Yeah. So and we actually never realize the uses of this, because, you know, I'm sure almost every home in our country will have a jar of petroleum. See, everyone is agreeing. A jar of petroleum jelly somewhere in the house.
Yeah.
You know, very like, you know, unassumingly, it'll be like sitting there for years together.
Yeah.
But we really need to understand the value that this gives us.
I also think it's one of the products that the men in the house also don't mind using. All you guys over here, do you ever land up like reaching for your wife's petroleum jelly because your hands are dry or your lips? I would see my dad doing it. All the girls are answering for y'all. There's one brave man who's raised his hand.
They don't want anything to have to do with beauty.
Like, but at the end of the day, if a girl's going to hold your hand, she might as well hold a nice soft hand, no? Instead of one dry, rugged winter hand.
Or not chapped lips.
Or your chapped lips. So what we've also done is, I know that you have a few hacks that you do use.
Yes.
And I've set up a table over there for you where you can take the girls through this perfect combination of taking the Vaseline that's in your house, some of the things that you have in your house, and bringing it together. So should we go over there?
Who's joining us?
One quick hack that actually I learned, that I learned a little while back, is that if you take the Vaseline and put it, and then you spray your perfume, it stays longer.
Oh.
Yeah. So I was actually
Chalo, that's
like,
what I learned today.
Can I have you here? The light is better. Yeah.
So it's simple. Is someone coming?
Is this okay for everyone?
Anyone wants a demo?
Yes. Yes. Okay for y'all? Okay. So as much as I would love that Sheed would try the hacks on me, I don't want to do that. So
we'll have to go into the shower after that, because the first hack
none
is
of them will come
pre-shower.
If you say that. No, we're going to make
it's
sure.
It's a pre-shower scrub.
Okay.
With petroleum jelly and salt.
All right.
Yeah.
So do we have anyone that will come and join us? Yeah? Okay, come. So, okay, what I'll do is, why don't you come first, and then I'll call you for the second one, yeah? All right. Hi. Come. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is Aina. I'm a fashion and a beauty blogger.
Thanks.
Hi, Aina. You want to try the hack on yourself?
Yes.
So take the petroleum jelly.
Okay. Yeah, we've got a mixing bowl over here for you.
Take some salt. Is that salt? Okay.
Could I request you to just get some tissues in case she needs it after this? Yeah.
Yeah. Just make it of a consistency that you would be okay scrubbing yourself. And that's it.
So now this...
That's it really. This is a pre-shower scrub that you can use on your body.
Okay. Yep. So do you want to just
it
try
it? It exfoliates and... Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Let's see what it feels like.
Yes,
it that's not
like
bad.
It, yes.
Yeah, that's not bad. And so much better to make it fresh at home instead of like buying something that's...
And salt is anyway a fantastic thing.
Yes. What? Which? Where do you all want her to come?
Prathmesh.
But I will also help you all do a photo shoot. And at that time also, she can come and stand here. Can we do this for the girls also? I promise I'll make it happen for you all. Yeah? Thank you so much. All right. Thank you,
Aina.
Thank you so much. And would you like to come and join us since you'd also volunteered? Another thing is also to use it on your cheeks. Because it gives you Vaseline. It gives you that lovely glow.
Tint.
Like a tint,
absolutely.
Right?
And
we're all listening, hearing about highlighters and all of that. But this would probably be like a natural way of doing it.
And it doesn't go away.
And it doesn't go away.
So the next one is the lip scrub.
Okay.
So you
are your lips feeling dry?
They will because there's lipstick. So eventually at the end of the day, lipstick tends to dry your lips.
It does.
Sometimes.
It does. At least it's matte.
Right.
Then it does.
Right. But so have you tried this?
Yes.
What
I
is
do.
It? Vaseline and
so
sugar.
Makeup, I always have applied lip balm or a Vaseline.
Okay. So the hack is...
do I need to remove my lips?
No. No, you don't.
You don't even have to use it. I'm just, you know... if you can just take some Vaseline. This is a lip scrub actually. Mix some sugar in it.
Okay.
And it's a lip scrub. You can use, that's salt.
Oh.
Sugar.
There's sugar. Yeah, the sugar's right there.
Okay, both look so similar.
Except they just have the name on it.
Yes, thankfully. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just and make just a mix like it a paste of the consistency that you would like to use, and and you can use it as a lip scrub really.
Okay, on top of lipstick?
No. I mean when you want to scrub
like
your lips. Lip scrub.
Yeah, but you can try it right now.
Okay.
There's no harm.
Take her lipstick off.
But you have lipstick, no? You carried some.
Yeah.
No? Huh? Exactly.
Okay. So you can try and scrub your lips.
Try
now
it.
With it.
Try it just so that we know that it's actually effective, because I'm sure a lot of the girls are like, wait, does it work? Does it not work?
This has a mirror.
Sure. And
helps.
It's sweet.
Yeah. It's quite silky.
Right. And is the is the sugar helping, like, just to remove the dryness?
Yeah, like the dead skin.
The dead skin, right?
Right.
All right. Thank you. Do you want to take a tissue?
So these are two simple and great hacks with Vaseline petroleum jelly
which
that I swear by.
All right. So I'm going to, I'm making you
take
walk a
back.
Lot.
That's
yeah,
okay.
I know. I'm
sorry.
Tired. So I just want to have like a little bit of fun now. Some of the questions I'm going to ask may be related to Vaseline. Some may not be related to moisturizing.
Okay.
But because I'm the MC, I get that liberty of doing that. So I'm going to grab the opportunity. But so just a few questions. This is now, don't think about it. Whatever comes to your mind, be spontaneous. I do not have a gift hamper for you.
Then I'm not answering.
Okay. So... what are the five things that you never leave home without?
Obviously, my phone, my house keys, my wallet, Vaseline petroleum jelly, and my ID card.
ID card, just in case.
Just in case.
Yeah. What was an early beauty advice that your mom gave you that you still love following?
Sleep well. Sleep a lot. Sleep enough. Get enough sleep. Sleep early.
Yeah. It also puts you just in a good mood, no, when you wake up the next day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Enough sleep is essential for almost everything in life.
Right.
From great skin to great mood to great work productivity to everything.
Everything. What's the one thing you got hooked on the sets of your last movie? Can I request you all to please stop talking? We can hear you all over here. Yeah?
Thank
you. Haan, nahi to yahan aake hum log sab baat wo bhi kar sakte hain. Thank you. What was the one thing that you got hooked on the last set that you were on?
Last set?
Yeah.
I'm hooked on to drinking a lot of tea on any set.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I'm addicted to tea.
So are we talking flavors over here? Or
no, just plain simple chai.
Chai.
Yeah.
Dood?
Yeah, a little milk.
Chini?
Yeah.
Best way to have it. Which of your co-stars is constantly raiding your vanity? Van.
Raiding my vanity? He's too little, but Tushar's son, Lakshu.
Aww.
I love to have him in my vanity van. And it's a task to even follow him, even in that little space.
He's like a hurricane, huh?
Yeah, absolutely.
What's the one piece of beauty advice that you gave your co-stars on set?
sleep well, sleep enough, go to bed early so that I can pack up early and go home.
But you were shooting a film where there were all these men who seem like they're so naughty.
But I needed to sleep, na.
It's like I can't imagine them like not doing lots of time pass. What is the one thing that you do when you wake up in the morning?
I drink lots of water.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I try to have a full bottle, but if
a whole
not,
liter.
Then, yeah, I try.
Yeah.
But I think that's the most important thing that you should do when you wake up. It's essential because your body is completely dehydrated while you sleep at night. So you need to replenish the fluids.
Right.
Yes.
Okay. So I've had a lot of fun over here and I think I'm done with all my questions. In case I haven't asked all of them and y'all still have a few questions that you would like to ask. So would you like to introduce yourself before you ask that question? I don't know if I'll be able to. I'll try and give you this mic. Yeah. Just can we have this mic on? Oh, wonderful. But sir, we're going to do a ladies first over here, huh? Yeah, I'll come to you. Okay.
Hi, my name is Srishna. Apart from Vaseline and sleeping, which is your favorite product from Vaseline? Apart from sleeping and this, petroleum jelly.
Deep resto.
But, and it's also probably something that's going to be very effective now in winter.
Yes.
Hi, Tabu. This is Pooja from News Nation channel.
Hi, Pooja.
Firstly, congratulations for
you.
Your Golmaal Again film. It
thank
has
you.
Really done well on box office.
It has, thank
what
you.
Do you have to say about that? And second, how much do you trust on beauty products? Like, aap khud kitna bharosa karte hai in beauty products pe? And how much do they help to glow the skin? Aur kitna bharosa rakhna chahiye aise products pe jo kehte hai ki aapka skin tone wo change kar denge? Kyunki kai ladkiyan jo hai wo bharosa kar lete hai lekin kai saalon tak beauty products apply karne ke bawajood bhi color tone change nahi hota ya.
So you know, I mean, today we're talking about
nahi ho rahi hai, hum moisturization ki baat kar rahe
hain. How much do you trust on such products?
So let's just stick to what we are talking about, which is moisturization, because honestly, none of these products are promising anything, so we
and
don't really need to go into that.
What can I say about Golmaal? I'm very, very happy, very excited. It's been a great experience, and it's great that the audiences have loved it so much. I really want to thank the audience for, you know, appreciating my work in it, and for, you know, I'm happy that I got to play such an important character in it. And मुझे लगता है कि आपके genetics, आपकी lifestyle सबसे important factors हैं आपकी practice में आपकी skin के लिए. You can't change what you're born with. You can just damage it or maintain it or try to build on it. और मुझे लगता है कि प्रोडक्ट्स डेफिनेटली हेल्प करते हैं, स्पेशली जैसे जेली और मॉइस्चराइजेशन की जब आप बात करते हैं तो आपको एक्सटर्नल हेल्प की तो बहुत ज़रूरत पड़ती ही है. स्पेशली मैंने एक्सपीरियंस किया है क्योंकि मैं इतने हार्श वेदर कंडीशंस में काम कर चुकी हूँ कि अगर मैं मॉइस्चराइज़र नहीं लगाती तो मेरी स्किन शायद फट के ज़ख्मी हो जाती. यू नो, सो या दे हैव देयर ओन वैल्यू. एंड
all right, I think there was a gentleman here who wanted to ask a question. He's fine? Okay, okay. Okay, so we have time for one more.
Hello?
And then, yeah.
Oh, sorry. Can
I? Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am, you go ahead since you've already asked one question. Thanks.
Hello.
Thanks.
Tabu, humne abhi jitni bhi baat ki, usme external aapne bataya ki petroleum jelly bahut achha product hai. Hum sab jante hain, wo karna chahiye. पर खाने पीने का कितना ख्याल रखना चाहिए स्किन के लिए?
बहुत जरूरी है. जैसे मैंने कहा कि लाइफस्टाइल जो खाने पीने को और आपकी सोने के साइकिल को इंक्लूड करता है वो बहुत ज़रूरी है. कुछ जैसे पानी है, आपको इंटरनली मॉइस्चराइज रिप्लेनिश रहना बहुत ज़रूरी है क्योंकि वो आपके स्किन पर रिफ्लेक्ट करेगा ही. आप खुद नोटिस करेंगे जब आप पानी नहीं पीते हैं पूरा दिन या आधा दिन तो वो आप अपने स्किन पे महसूस कर सकते हैं. नो, तो पानी पीना, फ्लूइड्स लेना और सही खाना. यू नो, कुछ न्यूट्रिएंट्स ऐसे हैं जिनके बिना आपके स्किन का लस्टर या उसका ग्लो कम हो जाता है. तो आई थिंक उसका ख्याल रखना बहुत ज़रूरी होता है इंटरनली.
और किसी भी ब्रांड को एंडोर्स करने से पहले किन बातों का ध्यान रखती है? वैसलीन तो बहुत अच्छा ब्रांड है,
इसीलिए तो कर रही हूँ बस. आपने खुद बोल दिया.
फिर भी
रेस्पेक्टेबिलिटी, क्रेडिबिलिटी और मेरी एसोसिएशन. मैं अगर उस ब्रांड से एसोसिएट करूं तो मेरे रेपुटेशन को हार्म ना हो, वो मेरे लिए सबसे जरूरी है.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you. You've been a wonderful audience.
And what I'm going to do is, y'all wanted that picture by the table, right? Y'all still want that? Yeah?
I'll okay. Just get my makeup.
Yes, we'll make your, can we have the makeup
person? 2 minute touch-up ke liye.
Yeah. Can we have the makeup person?